गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, माइसेल्फ मुंशी रशीदुल इस्लाम, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग, JIS कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग। टुडे वी हैव डिस्कस ऑन द जीरो फोर्स मेंबर एंड इन इट्स एसोसिएट टर्म दैट इज एक्चुअली रिक्वायर्ड एज पर योर करिकुलम। सो नाउ लेट अस सी द मेन पॉइंट। Now outline of this presentation, that means that points are discussed in today's class. First is introduction, second point is zero force member, now example of zero force member, reason for zero force member in a truss system, and last point is identifying zero force member. Now a zero force member is a member that means a single truss segment in a truss which given a specific load and is at rest conditions, so neither in tension nor in compression. So in a truss, a zero force member is often found at pins, that means any connections within the truss, so where no external load is applied and three or fewer truss member meets. So recognizing the basic zero force member can be accomplished by analyzing the forces acting on a individual pin in physical system. So the zero force member mainly contain that these numbers do not support load, increase stability during construction, added support if loading conditions changed. So this is actually the zero force equation conditions, zero force member conditions. Now the introduction part. If the pin has a external force or moment applied to it, then all the members attached to that pin are not zero force member unless the external force act on a manner that fulfill one of the rules that I mentioned below. So if the two non-collinear members meets in a unloaded joints, non-collinear means when the different types of forces are not acting in a same line, so that points, that type of forces are known as non-collinear members. So if the two non-collinear members meet in an unloaded joints, both the zero force members are acting on that situation. Now next, if three members meet in a unloaded joint of which the two are collinear, then the third member is a zero force member. Now the reason for zero force member in a truss system, these members contribute to the stability of the structure by providing buckling prevention for long splendor members under compressive loads or compressive force. These members can carry loads in the event that the variations are introduced in the normal external loading configuration. Identifying zero force members. Now zero force member in a truss are the members which do not have any forces in them, and there are two rules that may be used for find zero force member in a truss. So these are listed below and illustrated in figure. Now at a two member point if those members are not parallel and there are no other external loads, that means the reactions at the joint, then both of those members and both of those members are zero force members. So again I repeat, if at a two force member joint, that means if those members are not parallel and there are no other external loads at the joint, then both of those members are zero force members. Identifying zero force member. If a joint has only two non-collinear members and there is no external load or support reaction at that point, then those two members are zero force members. And in this example, members DE, if you see the figure, DE, DC and AF and AB are zero force member. You can easily prove this result by applying the equations of equilibrium equilibrium to joints D and A. So zero force member can be removed when analyzing the truss. Now the two members rule. If only two members form a truss and no external load or support reaction is applied on that joint, then the two members must be zero force member. So again I repeat, if only two members form a truss or external load or support reaction is applied to the joint, the two members must be zero force member. So this is the figure where DE, DC and AF and AB obviously a zero force member. Now if three members form a truss or for which the two members are collinear and the no external force is at the joint, then the third non-collinear member is a zero force member, that means the DA. Again, this can easily be proven. One can also remove the zero force member as shown on the left for analyzing the truss further. So please note that the zero force member are used to increase the stability and the rigidity of the truss and provide support for various different loading conditions. So the three member rule can also be described here. If the three members form a truss joint for which the two of the members are collinear and the three member is a zero force member, provided no external force or support reaction is applied to the joint. So again I repeat, if three members form a truss joint for which the two of the members are collinear, the third member is a zero force member and provided no external force or support, no external force or support reaction is applied to the joint. Now next, now this is the simple example of the zero force member problem. So if a truss which is actually connected with a joint, so the two points A and C are being actually tightly fixed, and the distance also be in vertical distance is 4 feet, and the loads are on a loads as shown in the figure on the truss. So find the force in each member of the truss. Now, for the calculation purpose, check if there are no zero force members. So first cases, checking is very important. So check if there are any zero force member. Number two, first analyze the pin D and then pin A. So point number three, note that member BD is zero force member. So FBD is equal to zero. So why for this program do you not have any fine external reaction before solving the problem? Now, so angle between the FAD and FCD, that should be in right hand side, and the total angle will be 45 degree, and also the left hand side angle be 45 degree. So summation of FX is equal to minus 450 plus FCD cos 45 degree minus FAD cos 45 degree is equal to 0 plus, then the plus summation of FY is equal to minus FCD sine 45 degree minus FAD sine 45 degree is equal to 0. So FCD is equal to 318 pound, that is actually 10 cent, and FAD is equal to 318 in compression. So FAD, FBD means free body diagram of pin minus summation of FX, summation of FX is equal to FAB plus minus of 318 cos 45 degree is equal to 0. So FAB is equal to 225 pound, that will be 10 cent. So that is actually the, so some questions, the one question is there, how would you have analyzed the joint C instead of A? Obviously this is actually the case where the diagram also be presented here, and we can easily replace the point D in terms of the point C for the changing the angle with vice versa. That means the right side angle is converted into the left hand side, and we can easily change the distance point with D instead of A. So thank you for today's class. Next class we can discuss with a new module and also a new topic. Thank you.